Hello, welcome back to the channel, and today we're going to show you how to use a WebSDR for receiving while on amateur radio. So let's jump straight into it. So here we can see that the K0NOC has left a comment on one of my videos saying, do I have any videos on how to set up and use a WebSDR to improve your receive? So yeah, I did reply and said I'd do a video. So this is that video, David, so hopefully you will see it. And the software that we're going to be using is my Station Master Cloud, Station Master Desktop and Cloud software. So if you don't yet know, if you haven't seen it on my videos, just Google Station Master Cloud and go to the download link and you can install it from here. Just follow the instructions. I won't go into that now because I've covered it in many videos. There's actually a video there you can watch that details how to install it and set it up. So once you've got this program installed, this is where we now can start using a WebSDR. Now, the majority of the users of this platform when I first launched it were in the UK. So by default, it will default to a UK WebSDR called Hack Green. So if we bring up a web browser and type that URL, this is Hack Green WebSDR. So you should be able to hear that. I think I've got the audio coming through. Normally you would have to move your frequency by hand. Now this is a multi-band SDR. So we've got top band 80, 60, 40, 20 and 17. 40 is the one I use the most. There's a few about, so we'll close that, jump back into the software, and if we click on the SDR tab, there we have it, exactly the same as what we were just looking at. Now the difference is, because we've got it in the software, we can automatically control this web page, and that's what Station Master does. So in settings, make sure you've got this ticked, set web SDR frequency to follow the VFO, and also have this ticked, mute on PTT down. So that, make sure you've got those two things ticked, and you can change this to any other web SDR. So if you've got another one local to you or a different one you'd like to use, you can put that in there as well. It does also support the Kiwi type of web SDRs as well. There is a bit of a delay on the ones that I've tested. So when you PTT, it can take about half a second or so before it mutes. So it's still workable, it's just not as... It's not as good as using the this web SDR. I forget who makes this system now, but this one works really well. So it all depends on the servers that are running it, I guess. But as long as you've got those settings in there and a compatible web SDR configured, and you're hearing it through your speakers, we can then move to the next step. So assuming you've got Cat Control up and running, and when you turn your VFO, the frequency is tracking as it's doing there now. If we look on the web SDR at the bottom, we can see that the frequency selector is also moving. Now that's me just turning the VFO. So if I turn to a frequency, say this one here, then 7135. If I scroll down a little bit, we can actually see in the box 7153. Sorry, I'm being dyslexic. And if I move the VFO, there we go. Now we can't hear anything at the moment because I haven't got the sound switched on, and that's what these orange buttons up here are for. So if I click the orange button, that will immediately enable the sound. I'll turn it down a little bit. So that's enabled the sound on the web SDR through the computer. If I click the stop, it will stop the sound on the web SDR. So you've got quick access to turn it on and off if you need to. Even while it's turned off, it's just muted effectively in the background. So I'll hit the SDR button to switch it on again, and I'll tune to... So all the audio we're hearing at the moment is through the web SDR. So this station here, let me turn it up a little bit, that's coming through the web SDR. Now I've got my... my transmitter is on zero power. So I'm going to dial away to where there's nobody transmitting, and I'll press the PTT button on the microphone. And notice that the sound has stopped. I've let go and the sound comes back. And if you look up to the top of the screen, when I press the PTT on the microphone, it says transmitting. At that moment, it's also paused or muted the web SDR. Now, so there we go. You can see that if I was talking talking on 40 meters, D key, wait for someone to reply. There you go. Automatic WebSDR auto mute. I think there's other programs out there that will do something similar to this. I've not tried them, so I can't tell you about those. But yeah, that's how you do it through Station Master. So if I change bands, or if I, let's say if I jump onto 17 meters, then it will automatically jump down there as well. My radio is now on 18130. If I turn the VFO, there we go. You can see it's just tracking. So there will be a slight delay on the audio coming through the WebSDR. There's nothing I can do about that. It's just because it's coming over the internet. But this particular WebSDR, which is called Hack Green in the UK, is very quick. The delay is very minimal. It's maybe half a second on a good day. It's certainly usable, and people won't know that you're on a WebSDR if you don't want to tell them. So there we go. That is it. That's how you use a WebSDR to receive on ham radio. Now, this is fantastic if you're at home and you've got S9 of QRM one day and you still want to go on the radio or join your amateur radio club net or something. Yeah, just fire up Station Master, enable the WebSDR. As long as you've got the cat control working and there's videos on the channel that will tell you how to do that, then it will automatically mute the WebSDR when you press the PTT. And that's the key thing, because if you're using Hack Green or another WebSDR directly through a website, you're not going to have that auto mute functionality. And I can tell you, after using it for a few months now, it's absolutely brilliant. It's you almost forget that it's even a WebSDR. So yeah, highly recommended. I know a lot of people use this when they've got bad QRM. There's a lot of Station Master users now. The platform is growing, which is brilliant. So thank you everybody that's using the system and giving me feedback and asking questions. It certainly is gaining in popularity. So that's brilliant. So hopefully I've earned a like and maybe even a subscription from you. So give me one of each before you go, and I'll really appreciate that. And you'll be notified, obviously, if you ring the bell. You'll be notified when I release the next video. That might be another how-to video like this, or it might be me out on HF somewhere playing radio. Thanks for watching. 73.